Hello everybody, today we are going to learn about how to generate mesh in ANSYS Fluent and how to choose the best meshing techniques and how to optimize the number of elements, like different kind of mesh method can create different quality of elements and number of elements, and we are also going to compare different kind of meshing. So basically we will discuss the fluent meshing which are available in ANSYS Fluent with fluent meshing, and we are going to discuss polyhedra, polyhexacore, hexacore and tetrahedral meshing in this tutorial. And please watch this tutorial till the end. So first I will create a sample geometry. For this video I am assuming this that you are already familiar with the geometry, and you might need some help in tutorial for the meshing part. So I will focus more on that part, and I will quickly go through the geometry in a kind of fast manner, but you can pause the video and can see these steps and generate the geometry if you want to follow this tutorial, or you can see some other tutorial on YouTube and can come back to this tutorial for the mesh generation, because this works with any kind of geometry with the methods I am going to describe in the next stages. So let me first finish the geometry, and for this part I would like to highlight that you need to choose this fluent flow, and fluent with fluent meshing, not the fluid flow fluent as I have highlighted. So you need this part because this is the advanced meshing for ANSYS Fluent. So let me start this part and start the meshing. You can choose double precision and number of processor for meshing and for solver. So let's wait for little and wait for geometry to appear here. And since I am using this for the first time on this computer, it is asking different kind of permissions. You don't need to worry about these initial stages. Just click OK for this, and this is the main part, import geometry. Since this is a single file, it's not multiple file, you can choose these settings and just import the geometry. Again, these are some formalities since I am using this computer for the first time for ANSYS Fluent. And after generating geometry or importing, you need to add local sizing. I don't want any specific local sizing, so you just update it, and you need to create the surface meshing. You can choose minimum and maximum sizing for surface mesh, but I will go with slightly change of maximum cell size. Or you can choose same, or you can also vary. You can play with these two numbers to see a different kind of quality of your mesh, or number of element, or chorus, or refined meshing at different regions. So just update this part and generate some surface kind of meshing or surface mesh. Yeah, now next step, you need to describe your geometry. So I am choosing these options. This is the single fluid body. So I am choosing the second option in this first part. And since my geometry is very simple, I am choosing these default options. And then next is the update boundaries. So since I have created named selection or name of the boundary in geometry stage, so here my name and different boundary came by default, we can change it, but since I have given name in geometry and the boundary type are accurate, I will go ahead with this and just update it. Then you need to update region, since I have only fluid region. I will describe it as a fluid part, and then we need to add boundary layers. Like here I will add certain boundary layers, so you need to keep in mind that this boundary layer will start from only walls, as the last grow on you can see only walls, and you can choose different number to see different kind of boundary, and then go to first update this boundary part and then go to generate the volume mass. So we will discuss these four kind of massing. We will start with polyhedra mass, and then we will go ahead with creating more advanced massing. So choose this maximum cell length and the growth rate. So if you vary this number, number of element will vary significantly. Just click generate the volume mass. Now you can see this massing, and so I am zooming to see properly at different parts. Yeah, so elements or cells are created beautifully, and you can see the boundary layer. So boundary layer are very important to generate, to capture the velocity or temperature gradient or pressure gradient near to the boundary, because near to the boundary the flow variables or gradients are really high. So you can see geometry or number or the how the mass is created at different part of your geometry. Okay, let me choose some default settings so I can see again that menu. Yeah, so and also you can check the massing at different plane using this feature. So you can drag it to see the mass at different corners, different plane or different part of your geometry. So this was the first part, which is polyhedra mass, and let me check the number of elements for it. So these are the surface element, and actual total number of elements for this massing is more than 150,000, around 158,000. So I will compare these number of elements for these four kind of massing. So generating these different kind of massing, the method is straightforward, because nowadays ANSYS is really really advanced. You can they have default massing with really good quality for most of the cases. So I am typing just a rough number for polyhedra mass, the number of element. Then this is the your second kind of massing, that is polyhexacore mass. You can see the numbers here, and this is significantly higher as compared to polyhedra masses. So let me type it here for comparison. So this is more than double actually. And then you can see the massing near to the boundary. So you can see polyhedra elements are created near to the boundary, and near to the core region hexa elements are created. So that is the reason this is called polyhexacore. It starts from poly, from the surface, and it create hexa elements near to the core region. And this is really effective massing if you have hexa element, because the orthogonal qualities are really good, and that is suitable for most of the condition. And the next massing is hexacore massing, and let me create hexacore massing and see the number of elements. So yeah, I will summarize these numbers as well as for the next massing, and that is tetrahedral. Overall point is you can play with these numbers and can generate the mass with different quality, with different number of elements, and can vary, can change the numbers, especially maximum and minimum size, to get the meshing for beginner or advanced simulation. So I hope that you learned something from this video, especially this meshing method. And let me go to the last kind of meshing, that is tetrahedral. Before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it, because that gives me a motivation to create this kind of video, and that also gives me motivation that the channel is actually growing. So please subscribe to my channel and like, share with your like it and share with your colleagues or friends. So again, the method is a straightforward, as I have described at the beginning. So number of elements I will just type there and compare with tetra. So here you are looking for tetrahedral meshing, and you can see the all the elements are tetra elements. There is no poly elements or no hex element, just tetra. And this is the reason that the number of elements for this kind of meshing are highest among these four meshing. So for summarization, I have just written the name of the mesh technique and number of elements. So for in my experience, with polyhexa meshing is going to be better in terms of the optimization of number of elements, as well as the computational time or power, as compared to other kind of meshing. Why poly? Because the hexa core have the orthogonal quality really good, and that might be suitable for most of the conditions. That's for this video, and please subscribe to my channel and like, comment and share. Thank you for watching.